creation. We celebrate this beautiful story. And from the beginning of time, people look to the heavens and they look to the earth. They look to the animals and the seasons and they ask, how did all this come to be? And so each and every culture, each and every faith, each and every age, from their observations, created a story. And it was a story they passed down and down from generation to generation, from grandparent to grandchild, to grandparent to grandchild. And so today we celebrate the story that was passed down through the Hebrew people from ancient Israel, through the generations of time, through that life and time of that beautiful man, the carpenter, the Messiah, the teacher, the friend. And now this story comes to us. And so we tell that story together. And so many of you, as you arrived here today, were instructed to go around and pick up different parts of creation that we are going to create the story of creation here before us as we go into that story. And so we have God coming forward to help tell the story. She wouldn't wear the beard because she says, that's not my image of God. So my image of God is one of pink striped shirts. Yeah. How about you? How about you, Louise? Doesn't God have a pink striped shirt today? And so if the children could come forward, because I'm going to use them as runners for those of you who don't want to run up every time you have something on your plate. So if you could get your plate on your thing, and then we'll either help you bring your parts forward as we tell the story, or the children will come around and gather up things from here and also from there.
Oh,
something brand new.
God spoke. Sky, in the middle of the waters, separate water from water. And there it was. God named sky the heavens.
So, over on that table over there is some bubbles. This is a safer kid thing. Come on, let's go. Let's go. I don't think anybody got the bubbles. There we go. Anybody else got bubbles around the room? Someone else had bubbles around the room. Here we go. There we go. Go blow bubbles all the way around. Okay, blow your bubbles all the way around. The sky is being created. The sky is being created. Here's your bubbles. Okay, bubbles all the way around. The sky was created. It's hard, you gotta stay away from the fabric's kind of slippy slappy. All right, perfect. That's okay, perfect. So just okay, perfect. And then God looked around. God looked all the way around and said, I have to create even something even more brand new.
So God said, separate water beneath heaven, gather into one place. Land appear. And there it was. God named the land Earth and the pooled water Ocean.
Thank you.
like sky, and decided to create something else brand new.
God spoke, swarm ocean with fish and all sea life. Birds fly through the sky.
There's like over. A fish over on the tables there. And I'll take that. There we go. Perfect. Go get the fish. Go get anybody else got fish around? Is there any fish swarming around? Any fish swarming? Oh, here we go. Fish and shells are swarming. Fish and shells are swarming all upon the sea. There we go. Oh, we got a light. We got a light of creation and fish and shells. We got a stray candle going. There we go. Fish and lights and shells and sea all swarming around creation.
Birds flying through the sky.
Birds flying through the sky. Birds. Anything birds?
God created the huge whales, all the swarm of life in the waters, and every kind and species of flying birds.
We got a penguin. Let's put it in with water and the bird creations. Kind of a combo thereof.
God blessed them. Prosper. Reproduce. Fill ocean. Fill the sky.
Oh, come on, kids, let's go look. Let's look. And God looked at creation and said,
"It's good. It's really good."
So God looked around, looked all the way around, and decided to create yet something else brand new.
God spoke. Earth. Generate life, every sort and kind, cattle and reptiles and wild animals, all kinds. And there it was, animals of every kind.
So where are the animals, kids? Let's gather up all the animals, put them on creation. Let them come to the earth. Where's the animals? Come on to you, bring your animal. There we go. We have bears, we have black bears. Oh, I guess. Yeah, pretty sure of the earth. Oh, she's throwing the creatures. Y'all just take it. There we go. Perfect. So here we go. All the creations of the earth. It's just building and building. So abundant.
God spoke, let us make human beings in our image, make them reflecting our nature. God created them, male and female. God bless them, prosper, reproduce, fill earth. Be responsible for fish in the sea and birds in the air, for every living thing that moves on the face of the earth. And yes, earth itself, and all that moves on the face of earth.
Whoa. So depending on what God's image of God's self was, never know, that might have been the original human. This kind of looks like our earth right now.
Then God said to the human beings, I give you every sort of seed-bearing plant on earth.
So, and then God said to the earth, let's listen. Let's listen what God said to the human beings. Let's listen carefully.
I give you every sort of seed-bearing plant on earth and every kind of fruit-bearing tree. I give them to you, all of you, for food. And to all animals and all birds, everything that moves and breathes, I also give whatever grows out of the ground for food.
And And God looked. God looked all the way around at the humans of creation, of the birds of the sky, of the fish of the sea, of the seed-bearing plants and the fruits. And God said,
"It is good. It is really good."
And after God looked at all of the work that had been done, all the children running around and creating, and the sky that continues to bubble forth, and God said,
"Heaven and earth were finished down to the last detail. God had finished the work of creation. God finally rested from all the work. God blessed this day of rest. God made it a holy day."
And so this is the story of our ancestors and our creation. And it comes with a message at the end that we are created in God's likeness, in God's nature. There is both privilege in that and yet also responsibility. And so children of the world, children, all here, let's come and sit right here. And let's look at our creation. Come sit right here. Can I have that ready for 1 second? And let us look at what we and God have created. And can we all turn and face the grown-ups? Can you turn and face the grown-ups here? Jackson, can you turn and face the grown-ups? And so we have a favor to ask of you. As the children of the world, we ask that you might care for the earth today. That you might work with us so that we and our children and our children's children might have an earth to care for ourselves, food to eat, animals to care for and to work with. So we as the children of the world, we ask, can you look with us, and together we will say and see that the world is good, that we are good in it, and let us care together for this great creation. And God said,
"It's good. It's very good."
Yeah, can I have you? You know what? I think we're going to use the bubbles after service because I'm a little concerned about the slippy sliding that might happen. Yeah, so I might take that. And then what we'll do is we'll make sure we put chairs where the slippy slide is, because I have to say, God's sky is very slippy slidey. So if you guys want to sit here and stay, we just have a little bit more of service to help us celebrate creation amongst us. Thank you, God, in a pink and white, pink and red shirt. And so let us watch and listen and remember